The Lee County Sheriff's Office is investigating video and images posted on social media of multiple boys having sex with a girl in the bathroom of South Fort Myers High School last week.
This story has received national attention, generated lots of rumors, and quite honestly, there's been a lot of judgment about the girl.
The girl's mother reached out to NBC2, sharing her pain and anger about how her daughter has been vilified on social media. She shared her story with NBC2 Today anchor Rachel Pierce. And Rachel, she's trying to protect her daughter. She didn't want to go on camera, but right. Her friend did.
And the mom was actually in the room when I interviewed the friend. So she was right there. She was approving what we're about to tell you. So the mother, she doesn't deny what her daughter did. But after reading the comments online, watching the pictures of her daughter circulating on the internet and video, she wanted to share her side of the story, hoping for some understanding of her daughter's tragic background.
Sex trafficking is a very traumatizing experience.
Sadly, Megan Eastrom sees cases like this all the time. She's the founder of Be the Light, an organization that helps victims of human trafficking.
She was a runaway, and that's how she got entered into trafficking to begin with.
The girl's mom brought her daughter to Eastrom after rescuing her from a human trafficker who had held her captive for 2 years.
She has been in an environment where she's been told to behave a certain way, and there were severe consequences if she didn't.
The incident at South Fort Myers High happened when the 15-year-old went to the boys' bathroom to talk to a boy she had a crush on. Her mom says the boy wanted sex, and the daughter complied. Then word got out.
She did not sleep with 25 boys in the bathroom, that there was only a small handful of boys that she actually did sleep with. It was more of a spectator sport.
It lasted an hour, ending because the students involved had somewhere else to be.
What's upsetting about this is that this behavior is not uncommon for human trafficking victims who have not gotten the help that they need.
The options for treatment for this girl were limited because she's a runaway. And while she was in numerous programs, none addressed the ramifications of sexual abuse.
She's not equipped with the coping skills to make a stable, rational decision in that situation.
She was in school only 2 weeks when this happened.
It truly is one of the most horrific crimes that you can actually have. I mean, it really is selling young girls for sex, and boys, frankly, for sex.
Nicole Wade is a former chief assistant U.S. attorney based in Fort Myers.
It was such a big issue that we actually started a human trafficking task force in order to educate law enforcement and the community and prosecutors.
The biggest misconception, it's not an illegal immigrant problem, it's a domestic one.
But what I don't think people really understand is that human trafficking happens everywhere. And it could be your neighbor. It could be, you know, the girl that's in your English class.
The pimps targeting runaways, outliers, and those with low self-esteem.
They've done it before, so they know what they're saying. I mean, you know, they know exactly the words to say. They know exactly what this kid needs to feel like, oh, I'm on your side.
And once in, it's nearly impossible to get out.
They are traveling and trafficking these girls from Southwest Florida to Atlanta, up to New York, up to Boston and back.
What's gonna happen to her now?
That's hard to say.
The girl's mom has pulled her from school. What Eastrom says she needs now is support, not judgment.
She needs to be prayed for and encouraged, not degraded and discouraged.
Victims are typically 14 to 16 years old. Wade says many traffickers find their victims on the internet and sell them online. And Peter and Kelly, the mother actually found her daughter on Backpage.com. So that is a popular site for sex traffickers where they go to sell these young boys and girls.
This girl's been through hell.
Yes.
Leave her alone. We confirmed today 16 students at this school were disciplined by the code of conduct. Many of them boys who were on sports teams there. Did the mom talk to you about what she'd like to see happen to them?
Okay, she tells me she's not pressing charges. Her focus is on instead on the people that are sharing this video of her daughter.